We have a lot of interesting programs on the radio. I recorded some of these. This one is in the series Sex Around Britain. Various sex in the shires by different people, different classes. This first one, I think, is by some old guy in the country. It goes something like this.
Good evening. We've come here to tell you about all the country things that we do out in the country. All out the rural districts, we're going way back when I was a little boy. Well, come rutting time, when all the young maidens are all getting into, as we say here, into bloom. You know what I mean? We get out the old maple, we stick it out the village green, and we grease it, grease it with cow's udder grease, nice and greasy, ready. And all the young maidens, they come out in their little narrow, flimsy little dresses and little skirts. And they sort of put flowers in the air and they start dancing round and round, and we play the sort of funny music, banging a drum and playing some little fruit thing, with holes in it, holes. And all the young swains come out, They're right pigs, the swains, really, but all the young swains, they come out. And they all stand around the outside, with all their cod pieces a-bulging. Because they know it's big rutting time, when the mangrove whirls are in firkin. And when the carrots thrust up through the mire, So it's come Michaelmas time, just gone the eve of mangrove whirls and fucking time. Oh, I'm sorry, rutting time. Sorry, fucking time is the night before. After a good fuck the night before, you need a good mangrove whirl, it's better than a cucumber because that's foreign stuff, Anyway, so it'd be spring morning, right, and all the young swains are on the outside and all the young maidens are on the inside, right? And all the young swains want to be inside, all the young maidens want to get outside, Right, but they can't because it's the middle of the ceremony, so they start dancing around this maple, all greasy with cow's grease, little drum playing, And round and round they go. And in the young maidens who are, as I said, on the verge of blooming, all the bursting out. Because the young maidens round here pads do love to burst out. A very good burst. They say to their mother, I do love to burst. So it's coming up nearly midday, which is bursting time. Which is, about an hour before the magic hour of frigging. Frigging is the evening time when they use the candles. They light the candles and they frig. Anyway, the drum is playing and the old mummers are out in the green, dancing around, mounted on his horses, his phallic symbols, where the cod pieces are bulging. And the chief mummer then cries out the old time cry of, let's get a frocking O. And everyone joins in and says, let's get a frocking O, let's get a frocking O, let's get a frocking O, let's get a frocking O. And they all dance around and they sing, right? And the girls lift up their dresses. And the young swains, they all are swainish, And their cold pieces start aborging. And they got those little leggings tied with that with a string round the bottom, It's a traditional costume. The reason for that is because they can get their trousers off very quickly. And the young swains bring on the best of the spring crop of mangroves, the biggest mangroves that they can find. There's nothing like a big wurzel to mangle a maiden. That means they love to be mangled. Under their short skirts, they are aching to be mangled. So they dance around a bit more. Oh, let's go fucking oh, let's go fucking oh. The old vicar, he's normally should be here, but he's not. He's off with the choir boy somewhere because he doesn't like this sort of thing, he's a normal, he's a God-fearing chap. He likes choir boys, He won't involve himself in all this rural heathen stuff. Anyway, the ceremony begins, as I say, with the two circling young people, the swains on the outside and the maidens on the inside. The swains start closing in, the maidens start getting all worked up, a blushing and a giggling, known as a frickling, because it's sort of pre-fucking giggling, So round and round they go again, and they're all beating the old drum, And then on a signal from the chief mummer, I don't know why he's called the chief mummer, because actually he's a father of about 5 or 6 kids, but, you know, he's a bit funny that way. He likes to dress in funny mummer's dress, you know? He's well known around these parts for doing this sort of thing. Oh, yeah. I mean, these idiots, are, you know, they come out and they dress with funny skirts and funny hats and little strings sticking out. I mean, they're all as... Well, they're all, let's face it, they're all pansy boys, you know. They go with the vicar. They go through the choir boys, they help him out, you know what I mean? Serve at the altar and that sort of thing, you know. Funny fellas they are. So, come midday, it be fucking time. And suddenly, with a great cry, they choose the mangrewurzel maiden. They take off her clothes and put flowers in her hair, and the swains hold her up high and they stick her on the maypole and they grease her. Sometimes the maypole goes right up at her mouth. So you have to put a rubber band around the bottom so before falling right down. And she likes this, because not only she gets a good fuck, but she gets a good blowjob at the same time. So she's going up and down, you know, like a weather vane on this. It is traditional for the young swains to take out the murgling bat. It's a nice piece of wood. And they hit her on the bottom, and they hit her, see how high they can, high she goes up the pole. And the one that is, he gets a free pig. You know, he wins a pig. Now, if he's into pigs, you know, he fucks the pig. But normally they like to fuck the maiden. So up and down she goes, this pole, you know, well greased with the K-leather grease, you know. So she goes up and down quite well. They don't need her too hard, because she might just jump off the top and go onto the church spire. I mean, last year the maiden had to be got down and called the fire brigade to get her down from the church spire. She got on top of the weather vane, you know. Anyway, up and down she goes, a gurgling and a gargling. And the maypole, by this time, he's been well greased, not only with udder grease, but with maiden grease, too. And she's going up and down faster and faster and faster, being batted with the wiggly bats. Was it fuckly bats? I can't remember. It doesn't matter. It changes from one minute to the other. You know, that's tradition. Oh, it depends how much the storyteller's forgotten his words before. No, but they don't do that anymore now. I mean, it's not done anymore. They know what they do now. They go around their cars and they throw keys in the ring, you know, that sort of thing. These old things are all gone. No. Oh, well, happy times.
A load of rubbish.